हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर कौशल किशोर सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट SNPIT एंड RC उमरा, भावेन बारडोली, गुजरात। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टॉपिक फ्लूइड फ्लो ऑपरेशन। सो हियर वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज फ्लूइड फ्लो, जस्ट बेसिक्स एंड इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट, फ्लूइड फ्लो ऑपरेशन। सो फ्लूइड फ्लो इज ए पार्ट ऑफ फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स एंड डील्स विद फ्लूइड डायनामिक्स। सो फ्लूइड सच एज गैसेस एंड लिक्विड्स इन मोशन आर कॉल्ड फ्लूइड फ्लो। सो इट इन्वॉल्व्स द मोशन ऑफ ए फ्लूइड सब्जेक्ट टू बैलेंस्ड फोर्सेस। सो दिस मोशन कंटिन्यूज एज लॉन्ग एज अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्सेस आर अप्लाइड। So, for example, if you are pouring water from a mug, so the velocity of water is very high over the lip, moderately high, so approaching the lip, and very low at the bottom of the mug. So the unbalanced force is gravity, and the flow continues as long as the water is available and the mug is tilted. So this is just the example of the fluid flow. And now we will see just the introduction part and basic definitions, like what is fluid mechanics, what is fluid statics, and what is fluid kinematics, and what is fluid dynamics. So just we will discuss in brief about these all four topics. So, following are the types of. So, this fluid mechanics is the branch of science which deals with the behavior of the fluids, liquid or gases at rest as well as in motion. So, thus, this branch of science deals with the static, kinematics, and dynamic aspects of fluids. So the study of fluids at rest is called fluid statics, and the study of fluid in motion where pressure forces are not considered is called fluid kinematics, and if the pressure forces are also considered for the fluid in motion, so the branch of science is called the fluid dynamics. So now we will discuss about the types of fluids. So following are types of fluids are available. So generally, like ideal fluids, real fluids, Newtonian fluids, non-Newtonian fluids, ideal plastic fluids, incompressible fluids, and compressible fluids. So what is the ideal fluid that we will see here in this in detail? So a fluid is said to be ideal when it cannot be compressed and the viscosity does not fall in the category of an ideal fluid. So it is an imaginary fluid which does not exist in reality. So this is just the definition of ideal fluid. And now we will discuss about the real fluid. So what is real fluid? All the fluids are real, as all the fluids possess viscosity. So whatever fluid we are watching, all fluids are real fluids. So now, what is Newtonian fluids? So when the fluid obeys Newton's law of viscosity, it is known as a Newtonian fluids. So next we will discuss in detail what is the Newton's law. So now, what is non-Newtonian fluids? So when the fluid does not obey Newton's law of viscosity, it is known as the non-Newtonian fluids. So now, what is the ideal plastic fluid? When the shear stress is proportional to the velocity gradient and shear stress is more than the yield value, so it is known as the ideal plastic fluid. And now, what is the incompressible fluid? So when the density of the fluid does not change with the application of external force, so it is known as an incompressible fluid. And last, what is compressible fluid? So when the density of the fluid changes with the application of external force, it is known as compressible fluid. So this is just the tabular representation of the fluid types, like types of fluid: ideal fluid, real fluid, non-Newtonian, Newtonian, and incompressible and compressible fluids. So whatever the density, it is constant in case of ideal fluid. In case of real fluid, it is variable, and non-Newtonian fluid, constant, variable, both it can be. It depends on the type of Newtonian fluids. And same in case of non-Newtonian fluid. So incompressible fluid density is constant, and compressible fluid density is variable. So density is constant, that's why it is incompressible. And this is the viscosity. So in case of ideal fluid, viscosity is zero. That is not possible. But in certain conditions, we are considering some less viscosity as a negligible. That's why we are considering that fluid as an ideal. And real fluid viscosity is non-zero. So here always we are whatever viscosity that we are considering. And in case of Newtonian fluids, so this tau is equal to mu du upon dy. So this is just the Newton's law. So this Newtonian fluid obeying this law, and non-Newtonian fluid is not obeying this law. So in case of incompressible and compressible, viscosity can be non-zero or zero. So this is just the properties of the fluid, types of fluid, and these are the density and viscosity is the property of fluid. So this is just the representation, and this is the graph between shear stress versus velocity gradient. So in case of non-Newtonian fluid, if we will increase the shear stress, then the velocity gradient will increase, and this straight line will occur. So this is just the Newtonian fluid. And in case of ideal plastic fluid, first you have to apply some shear stress, and velocity gradient will not appear, and fluid will not flow. So after a certain shear stress, it will start to flow. So this is just the ideal plastic fluid. And ideal solid means whatever shear stress you will apply, it will not flow. So this is just the ideal fluid. And this is the plot for non-Newtonian fluids. So there are many non-Newtonian fluids that we will discuss in detail in the next few slides. So in case of ideal fluid, if you will not apply shear stress at zero shear stress, it will start to flow. So these are the fluids. And fluid flow shall all kinds of aspects, so steady or unsteady, and compressible or incompressible, viscous or non-viscous, and rotational or irrotational. So some of these characteristics reflect the properties of liquid, and other focus on how the fluid is moving. So steady or unsteady flow. Fluid flow can be steady or unsteady depending on the fluid's velocity. In steady flow, the velocity of the fluid is constant at any point, and unsteady, when the flow is unsteady, the fluid's velocity can differ between any two points. So viscous or non-viscous flow. Liquid flow can be viscous or non-viscous, and viscosity is a measure of the kinetics of a fluid, and very gloppy fluids such as motor oil or shampoo are called the viscous fluids. So what is the viscosity? That we will discuss in detail in next slides. So this is just the we have discussed the types of fluids with the help of this graph. And now we will see what is the fluid flow equation. So the volume of fluid replaced in a given interval of time is called the fluid flow equations. So this is the fluid flow equation. Mass flow rate is equal to rho AV, and here rho is the density and V is the velocity, A is the area. So flow rate is area into velocity. So now we will see shear stress. What is the shear stress? So the formula to calculate average shear stress is force per unit area, and it is tau is equal to F upon A. So here tau is the shear stress and F is equal to the force applied on the fluid, and A is the cross-sectional area of the material with area parallel to the applied force vector. So now we will discuss about the fluid properties. So first we will discuss what is the density or mass density, then we will discuss specific gravity, specific volume and specific weight. So what is the density? As formula is written here, rho is equal to m upon v. So from here we can just define it. So the density or mass density of a fluid is defined as the ratio of the mass of a fluid to its volume. So this is just the definition of the density. So thus mass per unit volume of a fluid is called the density. So this is mass, and per unit volume is called the density. So it is denoted by the symbol rho. So this is the rho. And the unit of mass in SI unit is kg per cubic meter, kilogram per meter cube. And the density of liquid may be considered as constant. So while that of gases changes with the variation of pressure and temperature. So this is just the mathematical form, mass density. Mass of fluid, rho is equal to mass of fluid upon volume of fluid. So that is the mass density. And here rho is the density, m is the mass, and v is the volume. So the value of density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube or 1000 kg per meter cube. So this is just the density or mass density of the fluid. And now we will discuss about the specific gravity. So what is the specific gravity? Specific gravity is defined as the ratio of the weight density or density of a fluid to the weight density or density of a standard fluid. So for liquids, the standard fluid is taken water, and for gases the standard fluid is taken air. So specific gravity is also called relative density, and it is dimensionless quantity and is denoted by the symbol S. So mathematically, if we will see, S is here the specific gravity. So S is equal to the weight density of fluid, weight density of liquid upon weight density of water. So if we will divide the weight density of any liquid with the weight density of water, then we can find out the specific gravity of that particular liquid. So in a similar way, if we want to find out the specific gravity of any gas, then we have to divide that gas with the weight density of air. So thus weight density of liquid is equal to the specific gravity into weight density of water. So in case of water, we know it is the 1000 into 9.81 newton per meter cube, and the density of liquid, so specific gravity into density of water. So it is 1000 kg per meter cube. So if the specific gravity of a fluid is known, then the density of the fluid will be equal to specific gravity of fluid multiplied by the density of water. So for example, the specific gravity of mercury is 13.6. Hence, density of mercury 13.6 into 1000. So it will be 13,600 kg per meter cube. So now we will discuss what is the specific volume. So specific volume of a fluid is defined as the volume of a fluid occupied by a unit mass. Volume per unit mass of a fluid is called specific volume. So mathematically it is expressed as specific volume is equal to the volume of fluid divided by the mass of fluid. So if you will rearrange it, then it will be 1 upon mass of fluid upon volume of fluid. So mass of fluid upon volume of fluid is the density. So we can write down it as a 1 upon rho. So specific volume is equal to the 1 upon rho. So the specific volume is the reciprocal of mass density. So it is expressed as meter cube per kg. So it is commonly applied to gases. And now we will discuss what is the specific weight. So specific weight or weight density of a fluid is the ratio between the weight of a fluid to its volume. So thus weight per unit volume of a fluid is called weight density, and it is denoted by the symbol W. So thus mathematically W is equal to the weight of fluid upon volume of fluid. So it is the mass of fluid into acceleration due to gravity upon volume of fluid. So it is mass of fluid into gravity upon volume of fluid, and it is rho into g. So mass of fluid upon volume of fluid is the density. So that's why we can write down it as a rho into g, and W is equal to rho g. So the value of specific weight or weight density W for water is 9.81 into 1000 Newton per meter cube in SI units. So now we will discuss about the viscosity. So this, what is the viscosity? Viscosity is defined as the property of a fluid which offers resistance to the movement of one layer of fluid over another adjacent layer of the fluid. So when the two layer of a fluid, a distance dy apart, move one over the another at different velocities, say u and u plus du, as shown in this figure. So this is u and this is u plus du. So the viscosity together with the relative velocity causes a shear stress acting between the fluid layers. So the top layer causes a shear stress on the adjacent layer. Adjacent lower layer, while the lower layer causes a shear stress on the adjacent top layer. So this shear stress is proportional to the rate of change of velocity with respect to y. So it is denoted by the symbol tau. And mathematically we can write down this like a tau proportional du upon dy. And here we can put the proportionality constant, tau is equal to mu du upon dy. So where mu called is the constant of proportionality and is known as the coefficient of dynamic viscosity or only viscosity. So du upon dy represents the rate of shear strain or rate of shear deformation or velocity gradient. So from equation, from this equation, mu is equal to tau upon du upon dy, we can write down. And thus viscosity is also defined as the shear stress required to produce unit rate of shear strain. So here we can discuss about the unit of viscosity. So the unit of viscosity is obtained by putting the dimensions of the quantities in this equation. So mu is equal to shear stress upon change of velocity upon change of distance. So it is the shear stress force per unit area, and change of velocity length per time into change of distance 1 upon length. So it will come force upon length square and 1 upon time. So it will be force into time divided by length square. So this is the unit of viscosity. And in MKS system, force is represented by kgf and length by meter. So in CGS system, force is represented by dyne and length by centimeter. In SI system, force is represented by newton and length by meter. So in MKS system, unit of viscosity is kgf second per meter square, and in CGS system it is dyne second per centimeter square. So in this expression, newton per meter square is known as the Pascal, which is represented by a Pa. Hence, newton per meter square is equal to Pa. It is Pascal, and SI unit of viscosity is newton second per meter square or Pascal into second. So SI unit of viscosity is newton second per meter square or newton second upon meter square. And the unit of viscosity in CGS is also called poise, which is equal to dyne second per centimeter square. So now we will discuss about the kinematic viscosity. So there is a difference between viscosity and kinematic viscosity. So kinematic viscosity is defined as the ratio between the dynamic viscosity and density of fluid. So it is denoted by the Greek symbol nu, and thus mathematically nu is equal to the viscosity divided by density. So it is mu upon rho. Mu already we have seen, it is the viscosity or dynamic viscosity, and if we will divide it by rho, then it will be the kinematic viscosity. So the unit of kinematic viscosity is obtained as nu is equal to unit of mu upon units of rho. So it is force into time divided by length square into mass upon length cube. So it is force into time divided by mass upon length. And mass into length upon time square into time and mass upon length. So force is equal to the mass into acceleration and mass into length upon time square. So finally, the unit will be length square divided by time. So it is the meter square per second. It is the unit of the kinematic viscosity. So in MKS and SI system, the unit of kinematic viscosity is meter square per second, while in CGS unit it is written as centimeter square per second. So in CGS unit, kinematic viscosity is also known as stoke. Thus, one stoke is the centimeter square per second and 1 upon 100 square. So it is 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second. And centi stoke means 1 upon 100 stoke. So these are the properties of fluid. So here we have discussed, and thank you.